legal education, learned Attorney General, you must lead this country in a national conversation on this matter. We are better off having more young people trained in law, even if they are unemployed, than not giving them an opportunity. If you were to launch a manifesto, one community, one lawyer, you are assured of my support. One community, one lawyer. And maybe by extension, we can also even do it for medical reform. How much does it take to train a lawyer? How much does it take to train a medical lawyer? We say every day we are in deficit as a country in terms of their numbers. Yet, the Attorney General is looking for money to complete the 20 years building as quoted by Honorable Katie. Mr. Speaker, the proximity of that building to the new building of the Superior Court makes it more compelling for us to see it completed, so that the relationship between that office and the bench and service in the administration of justice will be better served. So, Mr. Speaker, I strongly think that, and there I disagree with the committee, when you state in your report that, and I'm quoting the Honorable Amuati just referred to it, that you would strengthen, there will be an article. Mr. Speaker, I want to quote the paragraph so that I can disagree well with them. That there, and I'm quoting from page 6 of your committee's report, it will also conduct and publish a research on the implications of the current policy in assessing professional legal education. Go beyond research. This country needs to have a national dialogue on the future of legal education under your auspices, so that we all debate the matters and appreciate how many professional lawyers do we need. Mr. Speaker, the Honorable Chairman and both ranking have dealt with it. With IOKO, they should get more focus. In many jurisdictions, Madam Attorney General, some of the invitations must be based on elementary prima facie. You don't go on a wild goose chase or audit report, forensic audit, and that is basis of criminality. Establish prima facie at your own level in order to guide. Indeed, you are told that no prosecutor embarks on criminal prosecution unless you are certain of an irresistible conclusion that you would end up at conviction. So you just don't go into every matter you want to investigate, you want to embarrass. No, you must. The evidential burden, gather it. Be certain that what you are nosing for will lead to a conviction, not embarrassed.